So you are saying that when you observe, you conclude, you give names, you do all these things. So that exactly is what is to be observed, Sanal. Kindly don't hold yourself guilty. Things are not to be observed. There are no things. When you observe things, you have to observe yourself. You are the things. If you observe a thing and you find that the mind is quickly coming up with a conclusion regarding that thing, then you have observed two things. The thing and the conclusion. So that's a bonus. You thought you were observing one, you got two. Why are you upset? There would never be a thing that would just be a thing for the mind. For the mind, everything is significant because the mind is both thirsty and blind. If you are both thirsty and blind, then you keep on groping about. Whatever you come across holds significance for you, because whatever you come across brings with it the promise of water. And you cannot know what holds water and what does not, because you are blind. You are thirsty, so you must grope and place your hope upon everything, right? Because water could be anywhere. So blindly you just go about and you touch this, and immediately a hope arises that this may have water. The mind will not be able to touch anything without according some significance to it. So it's okay if you look at something and conclude. Just as you watch the thing, watch the next thing as well. What is the name of the next thing? The conclusion. It's okay. Probably your trouble is that you have been told to observe without conclusion. Observe without conclusion. What does that mean? Observing without conclusion means observing the conclusion as well. Keep it simple. Otherwise, you will just one day suppress the fact that you do conclude. And you will go about the town proclaiming that you just observe and never conclude. Because the guilt will become intolerable. The wise man is constantly telling you to not to conclude, not to conclude, but conclusions are stubborn and inevitable. And you cannot bear being on the wrong side of the holy instructions for long. So then hypocrisy is the only way. You very well know that you do conclude, but you will start telling yourself that you don't. You will become a hypocrite inside and outside. No need for all that. Instead of that, simply say yes. When I look at that book, I'm reminded of the coffee shop, because that's where I first saw that book. That's okay. Fine. The mind lives in associations. Whenever I look at that book, I feel a certain distaste, because the last book I read from the same author didn't appeal to me. So even about this book, I have a ready-made conclusion that this one too would not be up to the mark. It's okay. You can see the mind concluding. When you can watch the mind concluding, then you are observing without conclusion. Deny that you are concluding and you are powering the conclusions. humbly accept that you do keep concluding, that you do have a need for security, even if it's false security, and you have withdrawn yourself from the tendency to conclude. Now the conclusion is there, but just as something to be observed, not something to be supported. Even in denying something, you support it, because to deny something is to get associated with it, right? When you just state the conclusion as it is, then you have withdrawn support. Slowly, gradually, the tendency to conclude would get feebler and feebler, and who knows?